Good morning. The last two lessons demonstrated standing wave patterns. However, it is important to realize they were all created using transverse waves.
Flippin' physics.
I thought it would be helpful to look at standing wave patterns created using longitudinal waves as well. Billy, remind me of the difference between transverse and longitudinal waves.
Whether a wave is transverse or longitudinal has to do with the direction of wave propagation relative to the direction of the disturbance of the medium. In a transverse wave, the direction of wave propagation is perpendicular to the direction of the disturbance of the medium. In a longitudinal wave, the two are parallel to one another.
Right. So this is what four standing wave patterns look like for a longitudinal wave. The oscillator is moving up and down at the shown number of cycles per second, or hertz, for each of the four springs. Actually, just like before, it is difficult to see what is happening at real speed, so let's slow it down to 32 times slower than real speed. And also, let's turn all the videos horizontal so the springs are bigger on the screen.
I still don't really see what is going on. Could you add the video echo effect? That was helpful last time.
Yeah, sure. So I can add that. However, I don't think it helps with understanding this time.
No, that is not helpful.
Yeah, I still do not see what is going on.
Maybe we should go back to that standing wave animation with the blue and red waves constructively and destructively interfering to create the standing wave pattern?
Good idea, Bobby. Bo, remind me of what the blue, red, and black waves represent.
The blue waves represent the periodic waves being created by the oscillator. And the red waves represent the waves which are reflected at the end of the spring and headed back toward the oscillator. The black wave represents the standing wave pattern which is created by the interference of the blue and red waves. And the black standing wave pattern is the only one we actually see.
Perfect, Bo. So let's remove the blue and red waves. And Bobby, considering this is a longitudinal wave, what is on the y-axis of this animation?
Well, when it was a transverse wave, position was on the y-axis. But this is a longitudinal wave.
It's density.
Well, that's right. Density is on the y-axis for a longitudinal wave. Thanks, Billy.
You're welcome, Bobby.
Right. So the density of the wave will be increasing and decreasing according to the pattern shown in the standing wave pattern. Now, to understand what is going on in the longitudinal standing wave pattern, let's bring back just the 33 Hz demonstration and adjust the location, size, and speed of the black standing wave pattern animation to better align with the 33 Hz demonstration. Now, do you see the longitudinal standing wave pattern?
I see it.
I do too.
Yep, there it is.
I mean, really, you can see the locations where the density increases and decreases the most.
Those are the antinodes, where the waves interfere to cause the largest amplitude.
Oh, right. And the locations of total destructive interference are the nodes.
That means the nodes are where the density of the spring stays constant the whole time.
Sure, nodes are where there is constant density, but the nodes are more difficult to see than the anti-nodes.
The animation does help to show where the nodes are.
That's true.
I do want to look at what happens when I pause the video while the standing wave animation is completely flat. At this moment, the density of the entire spring should be the same, and you can see that it is pretty darn close to correct. At this moment, the animation is completely flat, which means the entire spring should have a density which is at the equilibrium position, which means the density is constant, which is what you see in the spring. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you. Actually, you know what? Sorry, but there is one more thing.
Oh, good.
Oh,
sure.
Great.
The original top animation has density on the y-axis. However, we can also shift the animation over 1/4 cycle and have the animation illustrate something different about the longitudinal standing wave pattern. What do you think the bottom animation is showing now?
Well, it looks like the spring does not change positions at each of the nodes.
And the spring has its largest change in position at the antinodes.
Oh, so the bottom animation is showing displacement nodes and antinodes. Cool.
Correct. The top animation is in terms of density, and the bottom animation is in terms of displacement. And you can see how each of the density nodes is a displacement antinode, and each of the density antinodes is a displacement node. That will be helpful to understand when we get to standing sound waves in musical instruments.
Oh, that's gonna be fun!
Yes, Billy, it will. Okay, I'm done now. Thank you again for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.